just we discussed about trigonometric ratios and its functions. In trigonometry, we are using sin theta, cos theta, and tan theta. We already discussed about this one and this one and this one. This one we can write opposite side by hypotenuse, cos adjacent side by hypotenuse, tan opposite side by adjacent. So using these three ratios, we can do every problem from the exercise 11.1. I already explained second problem. Now we are coming to third problem. In right angle triangle ABC, with right angle at B, in which A is equal to 24 and B is equal to 25, and the angle BAC is equal to theta, then find the cos theta and tan theta. So cos theta and tan theta we need to find. Here A, B and angle is given, but sides are not given. First we identify the sides with the help of A, B. Is given a clue that at angle A is theta, angle A, B, A, C, this is my angle. What is the middle letter? A. At the A is theta. First I told you clearly, all trigonometric ratios derived from the right angle triangle, and right angle at B, so this is my B. Once again I am telling, read the question and draw the rough sketch first to understand how to solve the problem. This is very very important. Every time read the question and draw the rough sketch and identify what is given first. Here at angle B is 90 degrees, that the reason here I take a 90 degrees. Now, in which A is equal to 24 units, what is A, what is B and what is C? This is very very important. In properties of triangles, this is my ABC triangle. The angle A opposite side is called small a, keeping. B, the angle B, its opposite side is called small b. Angle C, its opposite side is called small c. This is the way to write the sides of triangle. This is the rule for all we have to follow, that's all. So this is my B, its opposite side is small b. Okay. And one more clue is given, BAC is equal to B, this is my A and this is my C. BAC, at middle letter we have an angle that is given by theta. These are very very important to do this type of problems. Very nice, very next one. See here, it is my A, capital A, and its opposite side is small. This is capital C, this is my angle, its opposite side is small. Now, we can write A, A is equal to 24 centimeters or units whatever. And angle, and small B is given by 25 units. A, 24 units and B, 25 units. Now we have to find cos theta and tan theta. Now, coming to problem. I told you so many times, in trigonometry, you are always using Pythagoras theorem. In a right angle triangle, we are using Pythagoras theorem. Hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. In right angle triangle ABC, at the angle B is equal to 90 degrees, then B square is equal to A square plus C square, since we write down by Pythagoras. hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. B square 20 pi square is equal to A square 24 square and C square written as it is, we don't know that. 25 is 0, 625 is equal to 24 is 0, 576 and you can write C square as it is. Here cluster will go that side, 625 minus 576 that is equal to C square. This is nothing but 49. You subtract it, we get 49 only. C square is equal to 49, then C is equal to root over 49. We know that if you remove the square, you can keep square root to 49. That is equal to 7. Yes, now I have 7. My C value is 7. Now I can easily find cos theta and tan theta. I already written here. So now going to cos theta. This is my cos theta. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side, this is my 7. My hypotenuse is cos theta is equal to 7 by 7. Very next one, tan theta. So tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. This is my opposite side and this is my adjacent side. Opposite side is 24, adjacent side is 7. Or, clear?